week 14 bump video. 14 weeks, very exciting. And the most exciting part is I am now in the second trimester. It is crazy to think that the pregnancy is going by this fast. I feel like the first trimester was like done in the blink of an eye. I think mostly because the first couple weeks that count towards your first trimester, you don't even know you're pregnant. So that kind of is something, but I'll be interested to see if my second trimester goes as fast as my first. I've read a lot of articles and things that say that the second trimester is the best trimester out of all the three. So I'm very excited to get into that and feel, you know, get my energy back and feel better and everything like that. And if you did notice, yes, I did. I just got my hair cut. What do you guys think? It's like really short. I didn't mean to get it that short, but I mean, it's fine. It'll grow back. My hair grows really fast, especially on these prenatal vitamins. I'm sure my hair is going to grow fast. So, and I really don't care to get my hair cut very often. So, you know, might as well get it really short once and then just have it grow back. Symptoms for 14 weeks. My nausea has finally subsided. Woot. I get it like very rarely, every now and then, but for the most part, I don't feel nauseous at all anymore. So it's so nice. I actually can eat, although I haven't really gotten back to my eating habits yet, but I hope to get back to it, soon. I am down a pound from my starting weight when I first found out I was pregnant. So that's kind of in the wrong direction, but I'm hoping to gain, more weight as the weeks go on. So the nausea being gone is the most thing that I've really noticed. I have been getting heartburn, although it's not like every night, every day. It just, some nights I'll get it and some nights I won't. Some nights I'll get it, but it really won't bother me, so I won't even take a Tums. If it is bad, I'll take Tums and it'll go away right away. I would take heartburn over nausea every day. Like this heartburn is not bad at all. And I love eating Tums. I have been getting a lot of headaches lately, which has been kind of annoying. Not really sure if it's like the surge of hormones or I've just not been drinking enough. I'm not sure. So I've been dealing with a lot of headaches. I have still been feeling really tired lately. I still go to bed at like 10, 10:30. I have been having trouble sleeping lately. I'll wake up and I'll just be so sore. My hips will really hurt, or my back. So this week I went and bought a pregnancy pillow. Actually, just went and bought it today. I bought the Snuggle. So I haven't tried it out yet. I'll let you know next week what I think. Hopefully it helps. My husband is not excited that I got it because our bed is so small anyway. It's going to take up a lot of room, but I don't care. I think next week I'll go and start like working on the registry and things for the baby registry at Babies R Us. I went in to go get my pregnancy pillow and it was so overwhelming. There are so many different brands of the same thing that I never know what's the best kind. There were so many different kinds of bottles, so many different cribs. You name an item and they had like 10 of them. So that was a little overwhelming and got me kind of scared, but I'm gonna go back at another time with my mom. She's had 6 kids, so I would hope she'd be able to give me a little bit of advice on what to get and what not to get. I still need to do a lot of research on strollers and car seats and everything, but again, I'm kind of waiting on the gender to figure out what I really want. So I think even if we start the registry next week, probably won't put too much on it because I want to get a lot of like gender specific colors and items and things like that. I have been feeling really thirsty lately. So I've been drinking a lot more, which is good because I'm probably not drinking enough. I haven't really had any cravings. Yesterday I was craving ramen noodles for some reason. I don't know why, it's like the most random thing. I have been really into mac and cheese too, I don't know why. Still not liking chicken, still not liking steak. or broccoli. Those are my kind of big things that I try to stay away from. In terms of cravings, I really haven't gotten anything like that serious. Again, like I always crave sweet things. I was craving chocolate chip cookies the other day, but I always crave sweet things, so I don't really know if that's a pregnancy thing or just a me thing. I have noticed myself like touching my stomach a lot more. I'll be rubbing it or I'll just like put my hand over it, like just like not even thinking about it. And Anthony points that out all the time. He'll be like, "Why are you touching your stomach?" I don't know. I guess I just notice it more. It has been, you know, it is sticking out a little bit more. Every week I feel like it sticks out a little bit more. I still think it looks kind of like a gut. And like you can't tell if I just am fat or if I'm actually pregnant. I'll show you my week 14 bump. So here is the bump from the side. Here is the bump from the front, and then here is the bump from the side. So I'm still using my lotion every day, and I think it seems to be preventing itching. I read a lot of comments of people who say that they have really itchy bellies because their skin is stretching, but mine has not itched like hardly at all. But you can see like there's definitely like a bump. But again, am I fat or am I pregnant? I don't know if people could really tell right now. If I wear like really tight fitting shirts like this one, like you can definitely, you know, kind of see a little bump poking out there. I wanted to show you guys our good friend Corey sent us a little gift for the baby, and I'm just in love with it. Let me show you. First, he got us this bear, and it has the UC Sea Paw on it. If you guys don't know, Anthony and I went to University of Cincinnati for college, and Corey went there as well. So he got us this. It's like baby's first teddy bear. It's super cute. He also got us these cute little onesies. This one's like a red one. This one is a black one. And then we have a white one. So now if we ever take baby to the football games, you know, at our football games, they're always doing a red out, a black out, a white out. Baby will be able to participate. So I just love it so much. I think they're adorable. Corey did not have to get that for us, and he did, and it was just so cute. I just loved it. I've been trying to keep more of a diary of every day. I have not been doing very well with it. Comment down below, did you keep a diary when you were pregnant and record your symptoms and how you're feeling every day? Or did you buy one and it was a waste of time? I bought one and like I filled it out when I first got it, and that was like weeks and weeks ago, and now I just kind of got it back out. I don't know. I mean, it's good to write all this down, but I'm also doing these vlogs. I'm doing the pictures that you see in these vlogs. So it's like, do I really need to, another thing to document this? I don't know if I'm just going overboard or what, but it's just kind of like it's the what to expect when you're expecting. It's the journal companion because I have the book, which I have been reading, but I have not been doing very good at reading it. And then I also have the journal. I have been really warm lately, like very hot, which is again weird because I'm usually a cold person. So that's one thing that I have noticed throughout my pregnancy is I'm just warm. I heard a lot of people say that when you're pregnant, you get very warm. So thankfully I'm going through like the cold winter months pregnant and not the warm summer months because I think that would just be miserable. I do notice myself getting tired a lot easily, not just like tired like I need to go to bed, but just like tired from everyday things. I just find myself being lazy, not wanting to do things just because I'm so tired. And it's not like I'm going out and like running marathons all day. It's like today I went out and ran a bunch of errands and now I'm just exhausted. Even though all I did was drive around and walk around, I'm just so tired. Like I just don't want to do anything more, even though I have a ton more things I should be doing. So that's really hard to like motivate myself to like clean, keep the house up and, you know, do these little projects and things because I'm just so tired. And I know it's because like, oh, your body's making the baby and, you know, you're doing a lot of energy, but it like makes me mad. Like I just want to get everything done. I want my energy back. They say in the second trimester your energy comes back. I have not seen that yet, so maybe it's still coming. I'm not sure. This week, baby is the size of a lemon, so bigger and bigger each week. A lemon's pretty big. If if you're asking me, I think that's pretty big. So that's really exciting. And they said baby, you know, can now reach and grab things. Baby can suck its thumb. So that's really cool to see. I wish I could feel it. I wish I could see it, but I'll just take the app's word for it. Still don't know the gender of the baby. Again, that's not going to come until Thanksgiving time. I have not had to buy maternity clothes yet, which is good. I have not had to change bra sizes yet, so I'm saving money on that for now, but I know eventually I'm going to have to go buy maternity clothes. I'm just impressed that I can still fit into my jeans. Again, like I wear more loose fitting shirts just because if I don't, then I got this gut sticking out and people are like, you're pregnant, you're fat, you know, people don't want to ask, like, they don't want to assume like, oh, you're pregnant, and then it turns out that you're not. So I've just been trying to avoid that. And well, I think that's all for my week 14 bump update. Stay tuned for next week. I'll give my review on the Snuggle and if it's helped or not, my pregnancy body pillow that I bought. And you'll get to hear more about, you know, symptoms and different things like that. So stay tuned for next week. Bye, guys.